in the right. Media, culture media, whatever preparing is that, it should contain the nutrient, right nutrients, so that a specific microorganism will be able to grow on it. Okay, that may be of your interest also. So that is the first criteria. The second criteria must be that it should contain sufficient moisture. Okay, so the media, whatever we are preparing, should contain sufficient moisture, then properly adjusted pH, and also it should have suitable level of oxygen. So that is the second criteria. Now coming to the third criteria is that the media, whatever we are preparing, must be sterile only initially. When you, before you start the culturing process, you have to take the media and see that it is sterile, and then you can put the cultures or inoculate the cultures so that the microbes and their offsprings will be able to grow in that medium later. But initially when you start, the media must be sterile. Okay. Now coming to the fourth one, we have to make sure that the organism, what we are growing, that is the organism, what we are growing, are able to be incubated at proper temperature. So these are the some physical parameters which is also very essential when we are preparing the culture media. So the criteria which is very essential for the media preparation is that it must contain the right nutrients so that a specific microorganism will be able to grow. Then it should contain sufficient moisture, pH, oxygen, which will support the growth of the organism. And the media, whatever we are preparing initially, should be sterile also, only initially, because later when we are inoculating the media with the organism, they will be starting to grow in that one. The next important criteria is that the media, whatever we are preparing, you are inoculating it with the organism. So the growing culture should be incubated at proper temperature. So these are the few important criteria. Now the media, whatever we are going to prepare, is going to be of two different types, is it not? So what are the two different types of media what we are going to prepare in general? Okay, one is going to be called as the nutrient broth. So what is nutrient broth? The media which we can prepare can be a nutrient broth, which is going to be nothing but a liquid media. Okay, so what do you mean by this is that you prepare the media, it is a simple liquid media, but it is without the agar, which is acting as a solidifying agent. So the media will be in what form? It will be only in the liquid form. Now how is it different from the nutrient agar? Nutrient agar says that it is a solid media. So in this case, we are going to add the agar. Agar is acting like a solidifying agent, so it becomes a solid media. Now coming to the nutritional requirements. So we are preparing the culture media. So when you are preparing the culture media, we are adding so many ingredients into it. So each one ingredient, whatever we are adding, is going to be supporting the growth and give a normal function for the growth of the organism. So let us see how these nutrients are able to supply the basic requirement for the growth of the organism. Now coming to the first one, we can see that it's a requirement for of microorganisms. So the source of energy can be again obtained from the radiant energy, or we can say that it can be obtained from the light source. So the source of energy can be light source. If the organism is using this radiant energy or the energy obtained from the light, then we are going to call them as the photo drops. So this is just a small classification of the organism based on their nutritional requirement also. But there are certain microorganisms which require their energy only from the chemical compounds. So we call them as what? We call them as the chemotrophs. Okay, so that is the first one. Second one, there is requirement something called as the source of electrons. So many organisms require them energy. The first one, the second one is the source of electron. So they can obtain, some organism can obtain their electrons from the reduced inorganic compounds, which will be a very good electron donors for the growth. So we call them as the lithotrophs. But there are certain organisms which will be utilizing the organic compounds as their source of electrons or a best electron donors for them. So we call them as the organotrophs. Then coming to the third one, there is requirement of carbon compounds. So the carbon source comes from where? So there are few or certain type of organisms which will use carbon dioxide as the sole source of carbon. Then we call them as the autotrophs. Okay. Then there are certain organisms which will require their carbon coming only from the organic compounds. So what do we call them as? We are going to call them as the heterotrophs. Okay. So now we can see that there is source, the nutritional requirement for the organism is in the form of energy. It must be supplied in the form of electrons. They require the carbon source. Now these are the main few required elements, but what are the other things which is also required for the growth of the microorganism? They require the source of nitrogen. Now, where can they get this nitrogen from? There are few organisms which will be fixing or utilizing the atmospheric nitrogen. Certain organisms also will be using nitrites or nitrates or even ammonia as a nitrogen source. Even there are certain organisms which can obtain their nitrogen directly from few of the amino acids. So this is about the nitrogen source. Again, there is other requirements also, that is source of oxygen. So how do they get the oxygen from? They require sulfur. They also require phosphorus. Now these are all required for the cell components synthesis. So it is also very, very essential. So they can get this one from various forms of the water. They can also get the oxygen from the molecular oxygen directly also they can get it, or from certain metabolites also during the reaction they can get it. Then the sulfur, which is very much essential for the amino acid synthesis. So they can get it from sulfate, they can get it from hydrogen organisms which will be amino acids like cysteine, cysteine and methionine. Then phosphorus is mainly obtained or taken for them in the form of phosphate, which is mainly essential for the synthesis of nucleotides. They are required for the synthesis of nucleic acids. They are required for the synthesis of phospholipids and so many other cell components they are required. Okay. Now coming to the next requirement for the growth of the microorganism are called as the metal ions. So there are certain type of metal ions which are supposed to be added for the normal growth of the microorganism. It can be like potassium, it can be calcium, it can be even magnesium ions and as well as the ferrous or the ferric form, you can substitute it. There are certain type of metal ions which will be giving them, we are supposed to give them only in low concentration. Okay, so we call them as the trace elements. Now, what are these trace elements? Few examples to say, it can be zinc, it can be copper, then it can be manganese and many more, like manganese, then cobalt, nickel, molybdenum. So what are all these metal ions going to act as? They mainly act as the cofactors for various kind of the enzyme action. They will be acting as the cofactors. Okay, now coming to the one exception is there, where one type of archaea bacteria is there, which is called as a red extreme halophiles. You could have seen that while I am writing these metal ions, I didn't write about sodium. Okay, so there are few organisms which do not require sodium, but there is one special type of bacteria called as archaea bacteria, which is called as red extreme halophile, which requires 12 to 15% of the sodium chloride. So high concentration of sodium is required for their growth. Now why they require is that they have to maintain their integrity of the cell wall. So that is one reason of their cell wall integrity maintenance, and also they require this high salt condition for stability as well as for the activity of various enzymes which are present in these microorganisms. Now coming to the seventh requirement. The seventh requirement is called as the vitamins and also certain growth promoting substances. So these are the other compounds which we also we should add it in the culture medium. So now, especially when coming to the vitamins, B complex vitamins are mainly required because they will be converted to the coenzymic forms, which is very essential for many different enzyme action. Okay, there are few organisms which can synthesize these B complex vitamins by themselves, but most of them will require this particular B complex vitamins to be added in the culture medium. Okay, now the other last most important one is the water. When this was saying about all the required nutritional requirements for the growth, the last one is the water, where all the nutrients, whatever we are going to prepare, must be made available in the aqueous form so that the organism is able to allow the entry of these nutrients into the cell and make a utilization for their growth. So these are the major type of the nutritional requirements which we have seen. So it starts from source of electron. Vitamins and water. Now, along with this one, I told that we are going to prepare nutrient broth as well as the nutrient agar. Nutrient broth is a media which is a liquid media, so we don't add agar to it. But in the nutrient agar media, we are going to add a substance which is called as the agar agar. The function of this agar agar is to act like a solidifying agent. It is obtained from the sea algae. It's a marine algae. It is agar is said to be as a complex polysaccharide. It does not have any nutritive significance. It's just acting only as a solidifying agent. Now, what is the significance about this agar is that it can liquefy at a temperature of 90 or 100 degrees centigrade. It can liquefy, and when this temperature is dropping down, it can undergo solidification also. So solidifies at a temperature which is dropping to close to that of 40 degrees centigrade. Okay, it's not minus, it is 40 degrees centigrade. Okay, so that is about the agar over here. So we can say that it is a complex polysaccharide. Its main function as a solidifying agent, it can liquefy at 100 degrees. And when the temperature is dropping from 100, at when it reaches close to 40 to 45 degrees, it can undergo solidification. Okay. Now this media, that is a nutrient agar media, whatever we are preparing, can be prepared and distributed into test tubes, as well as we can transfer them into the petri dishes. Now, when you are transferring, for example, you have taken a conical flask, you have prepared the nutrient agar media, you have even performed its sterilization. Now, from that one, you can take a sterile test tube and you can prepare the or take the media. For example, if this is your test tube which is plugged with the cotton over here, okay. Now what you are doing is that you are just adding the nutrients. You have liquefied the sterile media. You are taking it inside the test tube. And the test tube is kept in what kind of what position you see? It is kept vertical. So vertically, when you keep the position of the test tube, then you call it as a deep. The preparation of that culture media, what you have is called as deep. You take a test tube and you're going to place it in an angle. So this is the cotton plug what we have kept, and you're pouring the culture media and keeping the test tube in a slanting position. You can see now the media is undergoing solidification. So the test tube is kept in a slanting position. Okay, at a particular angle, we have to take the nutrient agar and place the tube in a slanting position. So then the media what you prepare is called as the slants. Now the slants, whatever you're preparing, can provide you a large surface area. So that sufficient amount of the space will be utilized for the growth of the microorganism. Okay. Coming to the petri dishes, they are all called as the shallots. Okay. You must have seen them. So they are, and you're going to fill it with the agar, which is the sterilized agar, and then you're going to incubate or incubated. So now the petri dishes is going to be called as the petri plates, or you call them as the culture plates. So we can see that by using the media what you're preparing, either you can prepare it as a deep, or you can prepare it as slants, or you can also prepare it as petri plates or the culture plates by transferring the nutrient agar, sterile nutrient agar, into the petri dishes. Okay. Now coming to the next component, what we have to see over here. Now coming to the next step, that is the procedure. How are you going to prepare it, and how are you going to check the sterility test? Coming to the procedure, what we said earlier, what are the ingredients supposed to add? The first ingredient is called as the peptone. Now, what is peptone? Peptone is called as a partially digested protein. Okay, so 1 gram. So coming to the broth also, we require the peptone, which again will be 1 gram. Then the second component what we require is called as the yeast extract. Then here also, we are going to take 1 gram, the second component. What we require, the second component is going to be the yeast extract, even in the case of the broth also. Okay, so here we are going to weigh 1 gram and take it in the conical flask. Third component what we require is called as the sodium chloride. So 0.5 gram is required, here also we require sodium chloride, and 0.5 grams we are going to measure and take it. Now the fourth one is agar. Okay, generally we go with 1.5 to 2% or 2 grams. Here, here we are not going to add agar. So that makes a difference between nutrient broth and the nutrient agar. Now the next thing is the distilled water. So we are going to prepare this everything only in 100 ml of the distilled water. Okay. Now the next important parameter is pH. You have to check the pH. It must be neutral. So by using the pH meter or by using the pH paper, we can check the pH. If you find that pH is not between 7 and 7.2, then you have to add an acid or an alkali to get it into that particular pH. So now I've told you the composition, what we require for nutrient agar preparation as well as a nutrient broth. Now the media what we have prepared, we can call it as a complex media. Okay, why it is called as a complex media is because we are adding peptone, we are adding yeast extract, and these things are going to have certain composition which is not known to us exactly what they are and what is contributing for the growth of the organism. So that's the reason why we call it as a complex media. So peptone is partially digested protein, so it can act as a carbon source, nitrogen source, yeast extract, vitamin, it is good in vitamins. And also there are certain other minerals also which can be used as a growth promoting substances. Then sodium chloride, whatever we are adding over here, is acting like a buffering agent. And agar, as I said earlier, it is acting only like a solidifying agent. It does not solve any nutritive purpose. Okay, so the media what we have preparing here is a complex media where you don't know the exact the chemicals. It is not an defined media. Okay, now coming to the procedure, how to prepare this media. So first what we do is that all these required ingredients, so these are the stepwise procedure. Let us just go ahead to see how to prepare it. So all the required ingredients are weighed as per the requirement given for 100 ml weight, and they are mixed together. Okay, you can take it in a conical flask, and the volume of water what we are going to use is 100 ml of the distilled. Okay, after is 7 or 7.2, you can just carry to the next step. But if the pH is not 7 or 7.2, accordingly you can adjust it with dilute acid or an alkali to get into its required pH. Okay, now what we do is that plug the conical flask, because we are preparing it in a conical flask. So plug the conical flask with the cotton. Once you are plugged with cotton, then you are going to put it for autoclaving. So this is a moist heat sterilization procedure. So just perform the autoclave for preparing the sterilized media. So after autoclaving is over, remove the conical flask containing the nutrient broth and the nutrient agar separately and allow the contents to cool the contents. Okay, now when you're cooling the contents, make sure that we are concentrating on the nutrient agar what we have prepared. So once when its temperature is like warm, which you are able to feel it with your hand, so that means it has reached to a temperature of 40 degrees centigrade, then what you can do is that you transfer it aseptically into a petri dish, which is also this is sterilized petri dish. So transfer aseptically into a sterilized petri dish. Okay, now after the transferring process, allow it to solidify. So after allowing it to solidify, then what we can do is that we want to check whether the chemical what we have prepared or the culture media what we have prepared is sterile or not, so that we can follow the same protocol for the cultivation of other microorganisms. So you can incubate it maybe for 24 hours, okay, and the temperature what we can keep is 30 or 37 degrees centigrade, which is a normal optimum temperature for the various microorganisms. So once you incubate it, then you can check for its sterility test. So next day after 24 hours, you can remove the culture plates from the incubator and check out whether the media is sterile. Okay, so these are the basic principle as well as the procedure for the preparation of the culture media. So thank you, students, and once the class is over, we will show you practically how this has to be.
Good morning once again.
Good morning, ma'am.
There will be a small demonstration of the experiment, preparation of culture media and then sterilization. So how it is going to happen? Practically, madam will demonstrate and will explain each step. Then you have to understand and then make a note in your practical workbook. Okay?
Yes.
So we will start.
Good morning, students.
So we have had the lecture.
Visible, na?
Is it visible? One of you can speak to us so that we will know whether you are able to watch what we are doing. Yes.
No, ma'am. It's not visible.
Camera.
No, ma'am.
Kindi kanan.
Ma'am, koncham kindi kanan, ma'am. Camera ni.
Okay, I'll show you how to.
Now it's okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So we have kept all the required nutrient broth, nutrient agar preparing ingredients are kept over here. So we have the yeast extract, we have the peptone, we have the agar as well as the sodium chloride. So all the four chemicals are kept. Distilled water also is available with us. So I've taken two conical flasks. Let us prepare only for 100 ml. So when you are preparing for 100 ml, make sure that the flask capacity is double the size of it. Otherwise, what will happen when you are putting it for autoclave, there will be chances for it to go up and then contaminate your flask. So that's the reason why you always take the conical flask, which will be double of its size. So I have taken 250 ml conical flask. Let us prepare nutrient broth as well as a nutrient agar in one of the conical flasks. So we saw the first chemical what we require, that is called as the peptone. So this is the peptone what I've taken here. So let us weigh. How much we have to weigh peptone for nutrient agar or nutrient broth?
1 gram.
Okay.
Yeah.
Visible. In your video.
So we require the peptone. So we have taken yeast extract. What is the role played by yeast extract? Yes, what is the role played by yeast extract? You're able to see it?
Yes, ma'am.
It's vitamin, ma'am, for growth purpose.
Yes, that is required for growth purpose. It's containing the complex vitamins. Okay, so today we prepare complex media. So the media is containing all these complex nutrient containing substances. Okay, we have even another media called as a chemically defined media also, where you are going to add each and every component into the conical flask. So for example, glucose separately you are telling that this is for the carbon source. or this is for the energy source. Starch you will add, then you call it as the carbon source or the energy source. Then you will add amino acids. Individually also you can add the amino acids. If I say growth promoting hormone, or growth promoting substances, then you have to add riboflavin, thiamine, pantothenic acid. Individually you have to add it. So when you add individually, you are knowing that what is the purpose of adding that particular ingredient into the culture media preparation. But here you are preparing a complex media, so the substance what you are adding directly will give you all the necessary requirements for its growth. Okay, so we will prepare it. One gram is going to be weighed over here. Okay, so what I am weighing is peptone. So make sure that the quantity what you are weighing is a good quantity. One, so I just take this one, put it into one of the conical flasks. When you are transferring also make sure that it goes to the center, because they always stick to the sides, so it's better that you transfer it to the center. And again I'll add one more gram. I'm not going to label them. You can tell me why. Why I'm not going to label them? Because one is agar, one is broth. So after autoclaving and when you're cooling it down, broth will be in liquid form only. Okay, so we need not label it. But still, if you are sure to make indicate the date of preparation, everything, then we can label it. So we are done with the first one, that is peptone. Now we prepare the second, add the second component, that is the yeast extract. So as you said, yeast extract is mainly, how much grams you have to add for 100 ml? Yes, students?
1 gram.
1 gram.
Anita, questions that I have future purpose.
So now I've taken 1 gram of the yeast extract. So make sure that all the ingredients what you're adding to your conical flask are in the dehydrated form. Okay? Moisture should not be there. If moisture is there and if your ingredients are not proper, any problem you have while you are seeing the bottle, better you avoid it. Otherwise, you will get lot of contamination. So now we are weighing the yeast extract 1 gram also. So after taking yeast extract, we will go to the next component. So next component is NaCl. So we have to prepare. What is the role played by NaCl? Is that it is playing like a buffering agent. So we require only 0.5 grams for the 100 ml of the media what we are preparing. So just 0.5 grams. So we have to take only 0.5 grams. So I'll add to one conical flask. Then we'll wait for one more. One for nutrient glass, one for nutrient agar. Okay, so we have given the sodium chloride also. So the last one which is left out is the agar. So I've added all the three important components. So one is going to be the yeast extract, then peptone. Peptone is partially digested protein. So what are the proteins you can use is, you can use a milk protein, casein.
We can use gelatin, we can use soya meat, you can, so like this, we have different kinds of the proteins which you can use them. So for agar agar, we will weight as 3 grams, 1.5 to 2 grams. Okay, so I weigh the agar. So it's a complex polysaccharide obtained from the seaweeds or the sea algae. Acting like a solidifying agent, and added all the required ingredients. Now, so we will add water. For distilled water, we can add, so it is only for 100 ml preparation. So after adding water, you have to shake it thoroughly. See that the ingredients mix well. Okay. So I'm adding to one of the conical flasks. Are you able to view it? Don't add everything immediately. I'm just adding into one of the conical flasks. I'm dissolving it, so you can see the contents are getting dissolved. While you're autoclaving also, they will get thoroughly dissolved and then it gets sterilized out. So it will take some time. While you are mixing it, make sure that it does not get attached to the sides. So in slowly, you just shake the conical flask and mix it thoroughly. So what we can do with the remaining 100 ml water is pour it along the sides of the conical flask, so that if any ingredient is there on the sides, they will go down and get mixed properly. Okay, so you can see the media is now ready. So this is 100 ml water. So first Newton broth, we have added the water. Now we will add 100 ml water to the nutrient butter. So what we will do is we will add in this one. Here also, after adding it, slightly shake it, because agar is there, it will not get solubilized. Perfectone, yeast extract, NaCl, it should get dissolved. So slowly you can shake it. So when I'm shaking it, agar is there, you see, it's not soluble. So it will get attached to the sides of the conical flask. So just shake it slowly. If you want, before keeping it for sterilization, we can put the conical flask on the Bunsen burner. And then you allow the agar to melt properly, then you can plug it with cotton and then put it for sterilization. That way also we can. So I'll add the remaining water. When I'm adding, you can see, rotate the conical flask slowly and then see that the media goes into the center. Okay, now we have prepared the broth, we have prepared the agar. Both of them are ready. So we have to just check the pH. So it varies. Since it is a nutrient agar, it is preferable for the bacterial organism. So the pH will be neutral. 7 is more than enough. But there are certain bacteria which may require less pH also, maybe 6 or 6.5. So depending on the organism which you want to cultivate, you can check the pH and get it to that respective pH. Otherwise, if it is for fungi, the media, nutrient agar, we don't use. We'll be using different type of media like Zapotox media. So for that one, the pH must be 5. Fungus grows very well at an acidic pH. So 5 is the pH. So what we will do is that we take the pH paper and we try to check it. If it is not showing in neutral, then we may have to I'm just adding a drop of it. So paper, let me check it out. So you can see that it is close to 7. You're able to view it. So 5, 6, and 7 is the last one. So 7, it is close to that. So I think it is sufficient. This is for nutrient broth. I have added agar in the other one. Let us check out what it is showing the pH. So you can almost close to 7 only. So I think it must be sufficient for it. Okay. So now we will, we have prepared the nutrient broth, we have prepared the agar also. Now the next step is we have to plug them with water. So let us see the plugging process. Already I have done 2 cotton pluggings for 2 chemical flasks. So what I have done is that we have 4 or 5 more experiments to be done. So based on those requirements, I have kept some of the glassware here so that we can see the packing of it, and then we will try to sterilize it also by using the autoclave. So you know, plugging, when you're doing the plugging, take a good amount of cotton and you can just roll it like this, and then you're going to fit it. Now when I fit this one, you can see it goes very smoothly. When I'm going to remove it, I should be able to hear the sound. So it is not coming, so maybe I will take one more small strip of the cotton and then roll it properly. Okay, so now it plays a very important role, plugging it, because you have to plug it in such a way that you should feel comfortable to remove it. Also, it should be in such a way that the sterilization is going to be proper. Okay, so I just plug it. Similarly, we'll go with the next one also. So we can roll the cotton and we can just cut. Okay. So now when I'm plugging it, I'm not able to hear the sound. I think we can add some more. Okay. Now we can So now we have plugged both the conical flasks. You can see the difference. One is a little bit turbid because of the agar. The other one is clear because we did have the agar. So after putting it with the cotton plugging, we just cover it with the paper and then put the rubber band. Okay. So this is first thing we have prepared. This is the conical flask. At present, I'm not labeling it. Once sterilization is over, we will remove it and then we will label it. And I'll show you something else also, which is a part of sterilization, packing of certain glassware. So I can take some paper and show you the packing of petri plates or petri dishes. So we need not take more. So we start with only 3. Don't pack too much. Okay. So just we will take only 3 petri plates at each time, and then we will pack it. So for this one, what we will do is that we will just take 3 petri plates. You know it has a lid cover on this. The shallow plate. So take it 3. So what we can do is that just keep it center and then start to roll the petri plate. When you are rolling it along the sides, we just make sure that there is a good cover. Okay. So that they don't overlap or some leakage. So I'll just roll it. Both the sides, try to roll the newspaper properly. Roll the petri dishes properly with your hand so that it gets covered properly on all the sides. Cover it maximum. Just take it. And then you stand rubber band to cover it on the other side. So we have got D1D petri. Now we require some tips when you're performing the next step of your experiment, the continuation of practical one. So better we will sterilize even the tips also, because sterilized tips are required. So we'll sterilize them also. So various size micropipettes are being taken for sterilization. Okay. And we require even test tubes also. Only have plugged it with cotton. So maybe there are a few test tubes which is left out. So we can just plug them also. So already the tubes were being washed and dried, and we have kept it ready. So now give one more tube.
Talk a little loud.
So we are going to plug it. So now what we can do is that pipettes also have kept it ready. So depending on the space in the autoclave, we will see how many glass pipettes we can keep. Maybe I'll show you even the pipette also. Pipette, when you are doing it, you should be a little bit careful, because it is a different volume you have taken. So what we can do is that one end we will just plug it, and then we can just put it on. Okay. So just keep it on the piece of paper, and from one terminal end you just roll it like this. I've taken 10 mm pipette. So just roll it, and wherever is the edge, you just fold it and then put the rubber band. So like this, first depending on your experiments, because we are going to keep it for sterilization. So first identify your experimental requirements. All experimental requirements, based on that, you can take up the glass plates and you can keep them ready for your sterilization only. Also, plant culturing as well as the staff cultures also. We have even serial dilution. So we may require some amount of, we may require some amount of the test tubes also. So we can just plug it in. I'm not taking too much because for safety reasons, we just take it directly and then we will. So we are going to do moist heat sterilization. So these are the set of glass plates along with the media. We have kept it. So moist heat sterilization, autoclaving we are going to follow. We are going to use autoclaving. We will show you. So we will arrange them in the autoclave and then.
Founded.
So we can take it to, these are the set of the plasmids and the media. So we are going to do sterilization. So this is the autoclave. So I think you are able to see. Children, are you able to see inside the autoclave? You can see the water. Okay, the level of water must be above the coil. I hope you can see the water is above the coil. Okay. So never the water must be below, otherwise heating will not take place and then the water will not come to its boiling point. If it doesn't come to boiling point, then the pressure and the steam which has to get accumulated will not happen. So inside we have one small attachment for it, inside where we are going to place all the glassware and the media. So as I told earlier, we have to place the glass plates in such a way that there is good spacing. Otherwise, sterilization will be improper. So we are placing all. So we have kept all the glass plates with the media inside. We are covering it with the lid now. So this is a small autoclave. We have the bigger one, which is vertical. This is also vertical autoclave. When you are closing the lid also, you should close it opposite. Screw it properly opposite. Very loosely you do initially only. Opposite, you should keep the screwing, so that there is no any space left out, otherwise there will be leaking of the pressure. So once you are set with all the knobs properly placed, then now what we can do is you can tighten all the screws. Once you are done, you have to check out this valve also. This is the release valve. So initially we should put it in the close. Once when the pressure is getting accumulated slightly, the air which is present inside, we have to release it out first. So that time we will release it. So tightening. After tightening properly, I'll show you one more component in the autoclave.
Okay.
Now, this is the gauze, which is important for you to see the pressure indicator it is. Okay. So once we switch it on, the heating element gets heated up, then the water comes to its boiling point, 100 degrees. And then again, because of the pressure which is getting accumulated, slowly the pressure inside the autoclave will increase and come to 15. So once when the gauze, this particular thing is showing you as 15, from there onwards you have to note down the time for 15 to 20 minutes so that the pressure inside the autoclave will be 15 psi also, that is equal to 121 degrees centigrade. Then the significance about autoclave is that it is undergoing complete sterilization. So as I told in the theory, it causes the destruction or that it destroys the microorganisms, vegetative cells, including the spores also. So that is why we are doing this step of autoclaving. Okay, so we'll switch it on. So it will take some time. So once it reaches to that 15 LPS, we will maintain it up to the 15 to 20 minutes. So for today, these are the steps. So after 15 to 20 minutes is over, we have to release the
pressure which has got accumulated. So slowly we have to release the, slowly we have to release the release valve, and then the pressure will be released out. Once when the pressure indicator shows coming to zero, then you can unscrew the screws and then slowly open the lid and remove your glassware on the media. So here now you can check for the sterility test. You allow and you can incubate it. So after 24 hours, if you are able to see there are no any growth of organisms, then your sterilization is perfect. So these are the scientists who must, you should get inspired by them. Barbara McClintock, so her work was on transposable elements in genetics, and she also won a Nobel Prize in 1983. So Ramachandran, you must have heard his plot, Ramachandran plot. He has proposed a triple helix structure for collagen, which was a fundamental advance in understanding the biomolecular structures. So the famous Ramachandran map is an indispensable tool in the study of molecular structures. So we have great people, scientific people who have contributed a lot in the fields of biochemistry and also in life sciences subject. So you people also should get inspired by seeing them and should do wonders in the field of science. Thank you, children. Have a good day.
So students,
yes,
are you clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts you have? What are the what is the pH for bacteria? I told you the culture media pH must be neutral, close to neutral. This is for nutrient agar. And remember one more thing, most of the time in many of the laboratories there is pre-mixed media already available. For example, today I showed you how to prepare nutrient agar by adding each and every chemical to it, like yeast extract, peptone, NaCl, then we check the pH, is it not? But commercially also there is the pre-mixed media available in the dehydrated form, like nutrient agar. So the label on the bottle will tell that this is the amount what you have to weigh it and dissolve it in 1 liter or in 100 ml. So you need not add acid or alkali to get the pH, because most of the time the pre-mixed media already the pH will be set to it. So you just have to weigh it and then you have to add the water and keep it for sterilization. Okay, so this is one more point you can remember. But generally when you're doing the project or the research, it is better that you add individually all the components, and when you're adding it, add them in correct proportions, because you are adding it individually. Even one chemical if you miss, then the organisms will not be able to grow on the media later. So that you have to take the caution. Okay, so there are different other types of media also present. So now we have switched it on the autoclave. It has started. It may take some time, I think so.